I'm sharing the easiest way to attract and feed native songbirds while turning your yard into a thriving bird-friendly ecosystem. If you've been wanting to plant certain plants to attract certain birds but have struggled, there is a great resource that takes the guesswork out of choosing native plants, and it's going to make your backyard birding so much more rewarding. I've also been using this tool to help me plan because it's a work in progress, but it's really helped me out quite a bit. Also, stick around towards the end of the video because I will have a bonus resource too. Before diving in, I just want to talk really quick about why native plants versus non-native plants. One of the things is it can help attract certain birds. It helps create a habitat for your backyard. It also increases native bugs. And one of the really interesting things about native bugs is that certain birds have more of a diet, like when they're eating bugs, they seem to dine on native bugs more than they would exotics. An example of that is the hummingbird, a few different species of hummingbirds, and some research has shown that 80% of the bugs that they consume are native insects. And then one of the final benefits that I think is really great, maybe it's two actually. Number one, if you like taking pictures of your backyard birds, it's one thing to do it on a feeder. It's another thing when they're on the plants that you've planted for them and they're actually using it, or they've caught a bug in that sort of habitat area. So it's just a really cool photo opportunity. And then that second like add-on benefit is just the fact that you get to observe and connect with nature, and it's all happening in your backyard, which is really incredible. The really cool thing is that there's a lot of talk about helping the environment. Getting started with native plants and building habitat in your backyard is an easy way to actually help the environment. So pat yourself on the back a little bit here. So the easiest resource that I found and use comes from none other than the Audubon. Now, stay with me through the rest of this video because I'm not only going to show you how this works, but I'm also going to talk about some really important considerations and how to manage that when you're trying to plant native plants, including the dreaded HOA or Homeowners Association. On the Audubon site, they have a great tool for finding native plants specific to your area. First, you'll go to the site, which I'll have the link in the description, and you'll enter your email and your zip code. And just so you know, they're not going to blast you with emails after you do this. You're just providing that so that you can create this plant list and have that sent to you. And then your zip code helps the tool figure out what plants are native to your area. After that, you can scroll down and you'll see some immediate results, but this is also where it gets cool because you can use that filter on the side. So say I want to attract cardinals, I'll click on that and then it'll narrow down the selection. Maybe I want to attract native sparrows instead, so I'll click on those and it will show me. Now it does say may attract, but it definitely puts you on the right track. You can also filter by plant resource. So say I really want to help caterpillars thrive, then I can select that. If I'm not sure about a certain plant, I can click on it and learn more. I can learn more about how tall it gets, where to buy. It also shows pictures and it shows what types of birds, like what other types of birds it might attract as well. Then you can also check mark that save box and that's going to compile your list. You can't buy directly off of the Audubon site, unfortunately, but this is going to help you in the planning department and help you find some reputable places to start sourcing your plants or your seeds. After you've saved your favorites, you can click Send My List at the bottom of the page and you'll get an email with your list. The email that you'll get will list your plant's name, and then to the far right it'll list the types of birds that it might attract. I'll say though that the formatting of this email could use some work, but overall it's still super helpful. And the good news is there's a link in that email to your list on a browser, and that's laid out way better if you click on that. And then below your list are places where you could buy the plants from. Planning and planting would be a whole other video, but here are some quick things to think about. If you're planting by seed, you'll want to learn when and how to plant. A lot of native plants need cold stratification. Basically, the seed needs a cold period in order for it to germinate. Winter sowing is usually your best option, and the good news is that most seed packets have instructions. When it comes to where to plant, you probably consider factors like, you know, sun versus shade outright, but you'll also want to think about places where your yard gets more soil saturation or where things are drier. You know, certain plants love a lot of water, some like a moderate amount, some like it pretty dry. It's obvious stuff, but it's things that I didn't think about right away when I was first starting out. Another really important issue is what I mentioned at the beginning of this episode, and that's your HOA. A lot of homeowners associations have rules about weeds and how tall things get, and sadly, native plants get mistaken for weeds. Heck, weed is in the name of some of them. The HOA thing is usually less of a problem for your backyard, especially if you have a privacy fence, but it can be an issue for your front yard. HOAs are concerned with eyesores, and to some degree, they're not wrong. Keeping the subdivision looking good is really important. So to have your cake and eat it too when it comes to your neighborhood and the HOA, well, your backyard is going to be where you can probably get away with a lot more, so that's your haven. For your front yard, look at plant heights. The Audubon's tool has some information when you click onto each plant. I'd say things that grow taller than 3 feet and can't be topped or trained, so you couldn't chop it shorter, I'd keep that out of your front yard to be safe. You could also just ask your HOA rep for the regulations about that and see if there's anything about plant height or shrub height. As you plan things out and consider your neighborhood and plant height, you can also plan to layer things. Presentation is really key. So have the taller stuff in the back, the shorter stuff up front, have little groupings and clusters. You also want to try and incorporate some kind of landscape look too. Your HOA would probably have a problem if you replaced the whole yard, front or back, with wildflowers, though. Wow, wouldn't that be really cool and amazing in the summertime and great for the pollinators? But yeah, that's not going to work more than likely. So instead, have a little fun with the landscaping and play a little bit. And then you want to manage it too, especially in the front. Deadheading is not always good because some insects burrow in the stalks of the plants and lay their eggs in there. And then flower heads become seed heads in the fall and winter that seed-eating birds depend on. But unfortunately, your neighborhood might not love those grim stalks in your front yard. So at least trim and care for the stuff in the front yard. Do your best to be conservative. Again, more than likely though, your backyard can be more of your full haven unless you have a really strict HOA or you have a neighbor who just wants to control you. So that brings me into another really helpful resource for sourcing native plants, and it's Prairie Moon Nursery. Their site has some incredible filters for size, state, soil type, bloom times. This site is really going to help you plan, especially as you get more and more into incorporating native plants in your yard. And then you can purchase from them too, which is great. And no, this is not sponsored or anything. I've used their site, I've ordered from them, and I've had really good experiences. Outside of those two resources, there are also native plant landscaping resources if you don't want to do this all yourself. So once you know what you want to plant, or maybe you don't know what you want to plant, you could look for a professional designer for your yard. To find native landscapers, just search your state and then something like native landscaping, or your city and then native landscaping. Other resources to look into are homegrown national parks, and also searching if your state has a seedling sale program. Some states do and can give you really good rates on plants. And then really just don't overthink it. You have time. Consider this a long-term project. Don't go planning a whole bird sanctuary right up front. I mean, you can, and that would be great, but to spare you from getting too overwhelmed, take it year by year. I also wouldn't just eject non-native plants that you have in your yard right away. They can still serve as cover for a while. I've been taking my transformation slow here too for that same reason. That and budget and time constraints, of course. But as you work to replace things, you can start to slowly take out the old exotics. Also, give yourself grace. There is a lot of trial and error involved in this, and just have fun with it. The good news is, even when starting slow, you'll probably see impact right away. And this is going to be that moment of huge joy when you spot your first goldfinch on some coneflower, or your first hummingbird on some cardinal flower. All of the work you did, and it all is paid off. It's doing what it's supposed to. And I can tell you, my first year doing this, planting the real native plants, not the stuff from the hardware store where the cultivars are different from what's natural. No, the real stuff. I had success the first year with growing, and I was so thrilled to see. So it's worth it, and you'll be so delighted too. Once you do have it going, take time to observe and see the connections. Once you start seeing this incredible network that you've built in your own backyard, you will feel more and more connected to nature. And you're going to see things that just take your backyard birding up a notch. I mean, it's one thing to see a bluebird at a feeder. It's another to watch them rip berries off a bush on a cold November morning. Tell me in the comments about your favorite native plant resource out there, or your experience when incorporating native plants into your backyard, or if you're just getting started, what are you hoping to attract? What kind of birds are you wanting to see in your backyard? And just enjoy it.